Welcome to this video. Let's solve some problems in your environmental engineering class. Today we'll be talking about one of the most important aspects in water quality monitoring. So, aside from determining its pH, clarity, dissolved solids, and turbidity, biological and chemical oxygen demand play vital roles in determining how polluted the water systems are. So, biological oxygen demand is the amount of oxygen required by microorganisms to break down inorganic matters. It is used as an indicator of organic pollution of water. So BOD is expressed in milligrams of O2 per liter, or simply parts per million, and can be measured in different ways. The most common method is carried out by mixing water sample with a small amount of microorganism seed. The example is analogous to adding yeast to flour dough. So the sample is tested to measure its dissolved oxygen, or the DO, before it is sealed in the dark to prevent further oxygen to be dissolved or generated by photosynthesis. So after 5 days of incubation at 20 degrees Celsius, the dissolved oxygen is measured again, and the difference between those two dissolved oxygen measurements is the biological oxygen demand. So it simply means it's the initial minus the final DO. Now let's try this problem. So a wastewater was analyzed using a 5-day BOD, and given the dilution ratio of 1 over 800 ml of wastewater per ml of BOD bottle. Now, let's calculate the BOD after 5 days and determine the ultimate BOD, the dissolved oxygen, initially measuring 10.26 mg per liter, is reduced to 7.45 mg per liter. The rate constant based on experiments is 0.23 per day. Assume this does not vary along the temperatures 20 to 30 degrees Celsius, and the same temperature persists in the sample and source. The formula for BOD is given by the BOD5 formula. This is equal to the initial dissolved oxygen minus the final dissolved oxygen divided by the dilution ratio. This is a very easy and a direct substitution problem. So BOD5 is equal to 10.26 minus 7.45 divided by 1 over 800. This is equal to 2,248 milligrams per liter, or simply 2248 ppm. So therefore, the 5-day BOD is 2,248 parts per million. Now we solve for the ultimate BOD, the total amount of oxygen consumed when the biological reaction is allowed to proceed to completion is called the ultimate BOD. Usually, it is represented by L sub O. In formula, we have the 5-day BOD equal to the ultimate BOD times 1 minus e raised to negative kt, where t is the time in days, and of course, k is a rate constant. In this case, it's 5 for the value of our t. Now, if you try to experiment and conduct a 6-day BOD or a different one, we just have to use this time, let's say 6 days, so instead of 5. Now, BOD5 is equal to 2,248 ppm, and that is equal to the ultimate BOD multiplied with 1 minus e raised to negative 0.23 times 5 days. So, just doing some algebra, we get 3,289.6122 ppm. Therefore, if the reaction is allowed to proceed to its completion, we will obtain the ultimate BOD of 3,289.6122 parts per million. If any case the test is conducted in a different temperature than in the sampling point, then a formula for adjusted rate of constant must be used. Typically, the adjustment for the rate of constant is given by this formula. So the new rate of constant is equal to the original rate of constant multiplied with theta raised to the temperature minus 20 degrees Celsius. So theta varies depending on the temperature range. So if we have 20 degrees Celsius to 30 degrees Celsius, then theta is equal to 1.056. If we're below 20 degrees Celsius, then theta is equal to 1.135. And then if we're above 30 degrees Celsius, then theta is equal to 1.047. So you might as well want to experiment, say the testing temperature dropped 3 degrees Celsius from the original source, then you need to find a new rate of constant first and then do the solving as what we have did before. Now let's try to make a little more complicated problem. So what could happen when a certain plant discharges wastewater to its nearby river like this one? A certain chemical plant discharges 3,000 cubic meters per day of its waste to a nearby river where it mixes continuously. At this point of mixing, the BOD is 8.75 parts per million and the dissolved oxygen is 5.43 ppm. If the resulting temperature is notably unchanging at 23 degrees Celsius, with the oxygenation constant equal to 0.17 per day, and reoxygenation constant equal to 0.21 per day, what is the oxygen deficit if the plant has discharged a total volume of 20,000 cubic meters of waste? So this kind of problem involves the Strudel-Phelps equation, which gives us the oxygen deficit at any time t. So let's just write the given. The flow rate of the company is 3,000 cubic meter per day. Our discharge point BOD, or simply the ultimate BOD, that is equal to 8.75 parts per million. And at the point of mixing, we have the dissolved oxygen as 5.43 ppm. The oxygenation constant is 0.17 per day, and then the reoxygenation constant is 0.21 per day. The volume discharge is 20,000 cubic meter. So in this case, we first need to find the value of the time in which the effluent mixes with the river. So solving for that, we have T is equal to the total volume discharge divided by the flow rate, and this leaves us to 20,000 divided by 3,000, which is also equal to 20 over 3, and that is approximately 6.67 days. So to find the oxygen deficit, we just need to substitute the values. So oxygen deficit is simply 0.17 times 8.75 divided by 0.21 minus 0.17. Of course, multiplied with e raised to negative 0.17 times the time that we have acquired before, which is 20 over 3, minus e raised to negative 0.21 times 20 over 3 closed quantity, plus the dissolved oxygen at that point of mixing, that is 5.43 times e raised to negative 0.21 times 20 over 3. So by simply using our calculator, we get 4.1415 ppm. So that's it. I hope you understand how we solve for the values of our biological oxygen demand when we're given with problems that simply involve the sample and, of course, those samples that are obtained from the point of mixing of a certain discharge of a plant. So, yeah. That's all, and stay safe as always.